Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Allen Bradley Control Logics processor. I have here an L62. This is just an L62B. It's not an L62S, so just keep that in mind if you're doing any configuring, that will make a difference. So it's an L62 processor. It's being powered by a 1756 PA72 power supply, and it's in a 1756 A6 six slot chassis, which is otherwise empty. So the purpose of our test is to test the capacity, the working capacity, and the health of this particular processor and how we go about doing it. So the first thing we're going to do is open up the RS Lynx Classic. This, for anybody that doesn't know, is a necessary software that connects the computer to the processor, and it provides a communication path between the two. And you can choose different communication paths. And the way we're going to do that is, today on this particular processor runs on an RS-232 port, which is in my port 1 in the back of my computer. That's a 9-pin to 9-pin connection. Okay, so what you want to do is, once you've got RS Lynx open, you want to go to the configure drivers icon, which is the squiggly wire type icon with connections at each end, and select that, and a window will pop up that says configure drivers. So if you don't already have your default driver up, you can go to the driver available drivers drop down menu, open that up, and you'll see RS-232 DF1 devices, and you can select add as new. Now, once that goes into the configured drivers menu, you can double click on it, or you can simply hit configure button, and you're going to go to a screen that pops up that says configure RS-232 DF1 devices. First thing that you want to do is make sure that you're on the right COM port, because that's something that's not auto selected. So again, I'm using COM port 1, and I've selected COM port 1 in this window. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit auto configure. When I hit auto configure, it's going to go through the baud rate, parity, stop bits, station number, and it'll change all those things based on what this is set for, this processor is set for. And it'll configure it, and once it's done configuring and it's successful, it'll say auto configuration successful. Alright, so we're going to say OK. We're good with that, and we're going to close the configure drivers window. And we're going to leave RS Lynx open, but we're going to reduce it so we make room for RS Logix 5000. So now this is the software that's going to get us connected, and again, the goal is to get this processor into run mode and leave it in run mode, and then we can check some of the details about it. So we're going to go to the top left hand side of RS Logix, select File, New, and you're going to get a new controller window that pops open. And the first thing is, at the very top is the controller type. Again, 1756-L62, the Control Logix 5562 controller. And I'm going to select that. Second thing that you need to know right below that, before we can get going here, is what firmware revision is it? And it'll give you, once you hit the drop-down menu, it's going to give you a bunch of choices. I happen to know that this processor is 13.40. So the major revision is 13, and I'm going to select that. Make sure that you know what your processor's firmware revision is. Okay. All right. Now the next thing is we're going to have to give it a file name. So what I usually do is make it. Mine will be ABD_L62test.acd, or rather just ACD, you won't get a dot. It's good for you to begin and end your name that way, and it will be accepted. It needs to end in ACD in order for the RS Logix 5000 to accept your program name, and then you go ahead and hit OK. And a new file will be created under that name. That's just this test name. Okay. All right. Okay. So the next thing that you want to do is you in the middle of the screen, upper part, right below where it says tools, you'll see something that says path, and it should say on a new file it should say none or no path. You want to hit that drop-down menu to the right, and you want to select the, it'll show your processor as ABDL62 test, AB_DF1, and that's the DF1 driver we selected before. So you're going to head, double-click on that, and now the path has been created. Now on the left-hand side, where the status of the controller is, it should say, once the path is created and the wheels are spinning next to path, it'll say program. That means that the key is in program mode right now, and it's waiting for further instruction. So, after that happens, you're going to get a connected to go online, a window that pops open, and it'll ask you what you want to do. Do you want to select a file to input, or do you want to just download this blank configuration that's here? In our case, as you can see, there's no other I/O, and I don't really want to have it driving anything. We're just testing the health of this. We're going to hit download, and we're basically downloading a blank configuration with the goal of getting the processor into run mode. All right. This is just to isolate the processor and test it on its own and make sure it's in good working health. Please keep that in mind. Okay, so now it's going to go through a download. The download is sort of brief, and once it's complete, if it's okay with it and there's no faults, you'll remain in program mode, the windows will go away, and you'll be able to turn this to remote program with no errors or faults, and run with no errors or faults, and then you can go back to remote run. So it remains in run. The RS Logix 5000 is going to show it's still in run in the green mode. It should not have any faults. If there's a fault, then there's something wrong with the configuration. Either it was expecting there to be some I/O modules or communication modules to the right, or in case you do have any I/O modules to the right, they have to be configured in. So just to make it easy, I usually make it just as you see it here, a blank file and a blank chassis. Okay, now that it's in run mode and I can see it's communicating through the RS-232, the goal would be just to leave it in run mode for a few days. And if you want, you can put something in here to block the heat from being able to escape, maybe something on top and the bottom. And this will create more heat, putting the processor under load. And you may want to do that just to force it into a situation to see if it does shut down, if there's an issue, that you'd be able to detect it. The next thing I do, of course, is go to the controller and right click, go to properties. And then I'll go to, once the properties opens, you'll have a window that pops open with a lot of file tabs. They'll give you general information about the processor, and that's where I learned that this is a revision 13.40. It'll tell you what type of processor it is. Above that, you'll see major faults, and to the right of that is minor faults. I would recommend that you go through these because this is where your errors are going to show up. And right away, I have my battery unplugged for a particular reason that suits me. And it's telling me that there's a check mark under battery, and it's telling me that there's a battery fault. So you can go ahead and clear any minor errors just by hitting the clear minors button and go about continue your test. After the 3 days is up, if the processor for some reason kicks itself out of run mode, you want to go back to these controller properties and see if it tells you exactly what happened. Go under major faults, go under minor faults, and take a look and see if there's anything that indicates what the problem was. All right. So again, leave it in run mode and always make sure that you have a good tested working battery. I wouldn't unplug it in your situation. I'm unplugging it because this is something that came in for a test and is not holding a program. But if you unplug a working battery, you will likely lose all your information. So you don't want to do that, and make sure that it's a good working battery. Also, this is something that you feel is troubling you, and it's something that you can't figure out just through the major faults and minor faults information and just the simple test that we've done, this is a processor that we do repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that interests you or you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.